In London, one of Farage's lunches has ended badly when he was asked to stop smoking.
Puritanical bunch of wankers.
Which is amazing. We had lunch, we sat outside on the terrace, and they wouldn't let me smoke. I said, what's the matter? Isn't the ceiling high enough? You know, it was absolutely unbelievable. We are being controlled by Puritans who want us to live forever.
Yes.
So that we can preserve ourselves for those last few bonus years.
Yeah.
We're not saying smoking's good, we're not doing that. It's a symbol of getting the state off our back. Big government. I can't stand it.
Well, that's your commissioner. I mean, the pensions are unbelievable. So it is a bit depressing to see what happens. But they haven't bought me.
But you have still not no German friends in the parliament?
No. Not Martin Schulz. Crikey, right. I'm actually one day, I'm going to walk across the chamber and punch him. I really am.
Mr. Farage, may I ask you something? Did you refer to Messrs. Clegg and Miliband as Quislings?
I certainly did, yes.
I should just like to point out that Mr. Quisling was the leader of the Nazi collaborators in Norway. I think it is inappropriate to compare democratically elected politicians with such an individual.
Oh, I'm not allowed to answer. Oh, fine. Oh, well, there we are. Isn't it lovely? He did it against the interests and the will of his own people. And the point I'm making about Messrs. Clegg and Miliband is they are refusing to accept a democratic result, just as Mr. Juncker is refusing to accept the Dutch referendum. There is something fundamentally wrong here. All I need is the right beer named after me. That's all we need. A proper British pint.
Good brand.
Pint of Farage, please.
Were you listening to the debate here?
I had it on the television in my office, yeah.
You were called a coward.
Oh, well, I'm very surprised they were as nice as that.
Rats fleeing a sinking ship was another thing that was
said. I've had 17 years of abuse here. I couldn't give a damn what they say. I'm not interested. They're upset. They're worried. And because they know that actually the UK is not the last country that's going to leave the European Union.
Governor! Winston! Governor! Give me a hug! Give me a hug, Governor! The world's greatest leader! The world's greatest leader! Listen, you guys, get that on your paper tomorrow! This is number one! Numero and uno! The world's greatest leader! Get it down now! Don't you forget, you heard of Muhammad Ali! This is the second coming!
I would think today in Washington.
Sorry. I can't hear you, mate.
Di questo Parlamento e delle funzioni istituzionali dei commissari. Questo lo dobbiamo non solo per il rispetto istituzionale alla Commissione, ma anche alla benevolenza della commissaria vicepresidente e alto rappresentante onorevole Mogherini. La ringrazio.
Right.
So, thank you.
And out of institutional respect, President, to the truth, perhaps you will understand and agree with me that within the European form of lawmaking, it is the unelected commission that have the sole right to propose legislation. If I'm wrong in saying that, you can throw me out of this parliament right here, right now, this afternoon.
Onorevole Farage, io la richiamo soltanto a un atteggiamento rispettoso.
I am just asking
Grazie.
You to be a little bit more respectful, please.
Prego,
thank
può
you.
Continuare.
You may continue.
Oh, I'll be respectful, all right. And perhaps you will be too, for the right of the leader of a political party that won the European elections in the United Kingdom in 2014.
I'm going to start. Have you been drunk in the last month?
I can't remember.
That's not a yes.
That's a very good answer.
Yes or no.
That's a yes. If you can't remember, it's a yes.
Have you ever killed an animal bigger than an insect?
I think I have, yes.
Yeah, what? Good.
No, but you see, I'm not going into all this.
Have you ever stolen anything?
I borrowed things.
The Prime Minister was better. Have you ever Have you ever changed the nappy?
Yes, in extremis.
Have you ever kissed a man?
Not in that way, no.
And carrying on from that, is Douglas Carswell cleverer than you?
I mean, in some ways, yes.
Have you ever punched someone?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever parked in a disabled parking space?
No. No, I don't think I have.
Have you ever lied in an interview?
Like this one.
Oh, yeah. Only on this programme.
Only on the programme. And have you ever flirted with a member of the European Parliament?
Well, I like to think that I'm doing my bit.
It's yes or no.
It's yes or no. To promote good relations between all different countries.
So that's another yes.
Let's move on to another quiz.
Did that go well?
It went terribly.
There's just time before we...
Good morning. Good morning. Thank you very much for that. Very warm welcome. How things have changed.
Just a second, Mr. Farage. Ladies and gentlemen, one major quality of democracy is that you listen to those, even if you don't share their opinion.
Well, thank you, Mr. Schulz. Isn't it funny? You know, when I came here 17 years ago and I said that I wanted to lead a campaign to get Britain to leave the European Union, you all laughed at me. Well, I have to say, you're not laughing now, are you?
Gracious Queen, long live our noble Queen, God save.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're calling time on Britain's membership of the European Union.